What's going on, folks? Checking in, off season, late July. We're getting a little closer. A lot of things going on a lot sooner, no pun intended, than usual. First, I'm going to update a few things. I know I've made a few promises lately, and at the time, I thought I could make them, but I'm still working on them. Number one, I don't know if I'm going to be able to make a hype video this year. I just, timing and everything, it's not that I incapable of making one, it's just timing and busy and work, school. I'll be making a move in the next, definitely within the next month. I don't know for sure. That's definitely happening. So my normal area will change. I thought it was going to happen about a year ago. Didn't happen a year ago, but happening this year finally. So getting a new place. I know there's a handful of you wondering where that 2000 monster video project. I've been working on it little by little. Takes time, but the problem is I have projects I'm doing with Full Sail, and those take priority. Because if I don't do those, I don't pass classes. I don't pass classes, bad things happen. So, but that is definitely happening little by little. Might have more time next month, even with the move. Once I get moved in, I have only one class I'm doing, so maybe I can get that done. Maybe hopefully I can get at least a part one before the season starts. Again, it's a monster project. This is not some 5-minute video. I plan to make this a three or four parter, maybe five, depending on how it works out. But I've got it outlined. I have a general idea of what I want to do with it. But it's just finding the right pieces and, I gotta write out, I gotta literally have to write out a script for this thing. This is not something you can just do on the fly. If you're gonna make it look good and sound good, you need to prep, prep, prep. Also, just to kind of get some thoughts in on the off season so far. I'm gonna get all the bad news out first. Obviously, we got some injuries, like obviously Michael Thompson, incoming D lineman, torn ACL, literally like a couple days into summer workouts. So that sucks. Jalen Redmond had some blood clots issues, and Lincoln Riley said today at the Meet the Sooners Day that they're gonna redshirt him for the year. So he was looking good in spring. So that really, really, really hurts knowing that what kind of a potential impact he could have had. Paris McKinney, Chance Sylvie, those guys are out. I know I'm probably missing somebody here, but like, here's the thing overall. I have a lot of faith and hope for this season. I think that OU has a chance to basically, I don't think I have a chance. I think they will beat everyone on their schedule. There's one or two games, at TCU, maybe at West Virginia at the end of the year, but like, again, by the time we get to the end of the year, I don't think West Virginia's gonna be that good. I just don't think they have the depth necessary to make it through an entire season in the Big 12. And by the time we get to Morgantown, how big is that game really going to be? Poss has a chance to be. But I'm sorry, I don't buy into Will Grier. I didn't buy into him last year when a bunch of people were screaming about him for Heisman, even before he injured his finger. Whoop-de-doo. So Will Grier is basically West Virginia's version of Landry Jones. And that's basically it for that. Everyone wants to know Kyler Murray, Austin Kendall. Kyler Murray is a millionaire now, gonna go play baseball next year. This year he's gonna be quarterback. I think it's an absolute joke that Kyler Murray is in competition with Austin Kendall. I'm not dissing Austin Kendall. I think he's good. I just don't foresee Kyler Murray not being the starter at the beginning of the year. It would be almost insane if he wasn't. His speed and athleticism will make that offense so dynamic. It's not even funny. And we know he can throw the ball too. Other things going on. Just recruiting is going great right now. OU has put together two back-to-back top 10 classes. They're working on this year. This year has a chance to be a top five if they get guys like Dax Hill and a few others. The barbecue's coming up in a week, the big recruiting barbecue. If you don't know what that is, it's a huge recruiting day for OU in the offseason. All the current commits are gonna, for the most part, are gonna be there. Some of the big time ones, guys like Dax Hill. They really need Dax Hill. If you don't know who Dax Hill is, look up Dax Hill, five-star safety in state Oklahoma. They cannot afford to miss out on him. They need to get Dax Hill. But I'm at the point right now where this year, I think Oklahoma's gonna have a solid season. I think they'll win the Big 12. I think they have a chance to go undefeated and make the playoff. Now, national championship wise, I don't know. It's too hard. It all depends if they get there, who they play, and when. So it all depends who you're matched up with. If you happen to be, now here's the thing. If Oklahoma can go undefeated and get that number one spot, the advantage they would have is playing in Dallas, playing in Cowboy Stadium, right? So they would play the number four team. So if like a Pac-12 team that's undefeated but maybe not as good gets there, or you get like a Michigan State who kind of sneaks in there, wins the Big Ten or whatever, that's your chance to get to the championship game. And then from there, you got a bunch of, you're going to take on a juggernaut no matter what in the championship. So, I don't know. It depends on quarterback play. Can they fill that spot at left tackle left by Orlando Brown? Cody Ford is going to be playing tackle a little bit this year. We'll see how he fares. I don't think Bobby Evans is going to move to left. I think they want to keep him there at right tackle. So there's that going on. But the offensive line is going to be good. I think Creed Humphrey or Drew Samia are going to do a fantastic, is it Jonathan Alvarez? I think Creed Humphrey is going to be the center, but that's just me. I just think he's a mauler. Brandon Radley Howells, do I need to say anything more about Buki? How good he's going to be? How everyone's expecting him to be awesome? Corner depth is awesome. Safety is a little bit of an issue, because you have Prince McKinney and Chance Sylvie, and just like, you know, obviously Buki's going to take one of those spots, but you know, it's going to be Khalil Houghton, and maybe Jordan Parker's going to play safety this year. There's talk about him doing that. So depth at safety is a little concerning. You got some potential really good playmakers there, but if anybody gets hurt, I'm not too confident about the safety position right now, depth-wise. Starters, I'm okay with. Depth, not really. Other than that, I love the schedule this year. They have a ton of home games. I think OU's got a real shot to do something special this year. And got a chance to win 4 Big 12 championships in a row. I don't know about a Heisman, you know, Rodney Anderson, you know, Kyler Murray, you know, like Marquise Brown maybe even. Who knows? Like, the offense is going to be good, guys. The question is, can this defense, who's starting to get some real talent, legitimate talent for the first time in a while, where almost nearly every position has got super talented guys, can they put it all together? Can they put it all together? And I'm not asking for much. Give me a top 30 defense. That's what I'm asking. I don't need top 5. I don't need top 10. I'm not even 15 or 20. Give me top 30. Something respectable. Can we shut down most of the opponents on the schedule? I know some games are going to be shootouts, but come on. Can we shut down the ones that are, you know, inferior? Because there were some games last year with Tulane, and there were, granted, the kinks got worked out, but like, I want to see more games like OU had against Ohio State defensively. Defensively, they played really well. I think there's a lot of potential there. Linebacking, you know, has a chance to be good. Caleb Kelly's back. Kenneth Murray, I'm excited about him. I know some people are down on him because of the Rose Bowl, but, you know, he was put in there as a true freshman. I think that guy gets it. We'll see if that translates on the field. But overall, again, I'm going in circles. Really excited about the team this year. Other than that, that's all I got. Those are just some updates going on. I'll try to work on some stuff. But other than that, super busy with school and work, and I just want to drop in mid-July and say hello to everyone. So with that being said, I'm out, and y'all enjoy your work week.